In this video, I'm going to show you a fun little blitz that you can utilize against trip sets, whether it be trips tight end, gun trips, gun tray open. It's a really, really good blitz whenever the tight end is not able to pick up pressure from the three wide receiver side. Now, if you're new to the channel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I upload new videos every single day that can help you become a better Madden player. And in today's video, we're talking about a five-man pressure concept that I absolutely love, specifically for defending trips tight end or tray type of formations. Now, today we're talking about the nickel triple formation. This is can be found in the Chicago Bears defensive playbook. I've got a full ebook on this defense. If you want to learn more about this defense, or if you want to take your Madden game to the next level, make sure that you join my Patreon. For just $10 a month, you're going to get access to all of my Madden 22 offensive and defensive ebooks that I've released so far, and all the ebooks that I've got coming here in the very near future. We're releasing an ebook today on some stuff as well. We got a lot of stuff coming for you in the Patreon. I just released a five wide mini scheme yesterday, so a lot of really good stuff over there for you. If you want to sign up for it, again, there's going to be a link in the description. Now, guys, I'm really, really excited to share this concept. I was actually it's very good for tray formations. It's also really good for these tray Y flex PA crossers type of play. We're going to start with this video on PA crossers, then I'm going to show you how it works against trips tight end. But it's very, very good specifically for tray Y flex because of how little they can pick up pressure-wise within this formation. You can do this out of any play in the defense. My personal preference is to do this out of a cover three cloud type of look, but you can do this out of anything, okay? I love cover three cloud though. So you see here, this is kind of how the defense looks against this package. Now, if I were to man align, I want you to notice that if I man align here, nothing really changes. You're going to see that the defense basically is the defense. The other cool part about nickel triple is if you take a look at these linebackers, especially against cover three cloud, cover six, some of those defenses, you don't get this linebacker bouncing to the outside, which I think is very beneficial. Now, literally for the setup, all we're going to do is globally blitz our linebackers. And once we do that, we're going to stand right over that left of screen defense or left of screen tackle. So you can see we're standing over the left of screen tackle. Make sure that you pass commit, and that's pretty much it. And what you're going to see here is this pressure is going to come in. It's going to really scare them, and it's going to make it darn near impossible to throw the ball, even if they block a running back. As you saw right there, it's very, very hard for them to be able to throw the ball against this look. So again, I'm just going to stand kind of right here. And then you see right, see how that animation, see what happens? A lot of times what people are going to do whenever they're trying to pick up this pressure is they're going to try to like release the running back to go over there and block. So they're going to hit right trigger. If they hit right trigger, 9 times out of 10, you're going to get even better pressure. Now you do want to come down just enough for that tackle to engage with you. I didn't do that right there. I love to give this look right here. And again, he comes down, engages. See that right there? See how they'll freeze? And it'll freeze up the offense. And it's very difficult to be able to pick this blitz up. What's a better strategy for trying to pick this blitz up is actually letting the play action run. The problem with that is the animation, you can get sucked into animations here. And you'll see he'll push the pocket. And then almost always, it's very difficult to escape out. You've got contain on both sides. If you want to contain, you certainly can out of this blitz. Let me show you this. If you want to contain, you can. But notice, you see how that kind of glitches out the pressure on that left side. So if you're going to do that, what I would recommend doing is global blitzing, containing, and then re-blitzing manually that left side guy. So you see it looks kind of like this. This right here is a really, really good, because they're going to roll into that contain right there. I didn't pass commit. That's why he tackled the running back. If you pass commit, he's going to get that instant shed animation. And I'm telling you right now, I've had a ton of success with this. Now, of course, if they put the running back on a route, so let's say they put their running back on a pass catch route, you should get pressure either one way or the other. You're going to get pressure off of one edge. Typically, the pressure will come. Typically, the pressure will come off of this left side. So again, you see how I'm kind of standing right here. I'm just holding left trigger, snap the ball, and you see right there the pressure comes in. So if they send five out, you're going to get pressure. But if they block their running back, what I really like about this, specifically if they block them in that play action, which is very popular, then you're going to get this pressure off of this side. Now, again, this is why I really like to recommend that you want to contain the quarterback rollout side, which for me and for most people is going to be this right side, but then you want to re-blitz on the left side. So you see how it looks like that? Then what we're going to do here is if they block their running back, now you've got that contain logic that typically will loop right around the back. You get great sheds because you're a nickel triple, and that's one of the many reasons why this formation is so, so good. Now, I'm going to show you this against trips tight end and explain why it's basically the same thing. I'm going to do that with PA Counter Go, one of the best pass protection concepts in this game. We'll do it out of Cover 3 Sky for this. You could also, like I said, do it out of Cover 3 Cloud. The only difference is you notice here you're going to get a man aligned look from Cover 3 Cloud. And the only reason why that's significant is you might need to go ahead and show blitz and put a little put somebody over there in a hard flat or a curl flat type of situation. You know, maybe you do something like this, if you will, and then you man lock on the backside. But you're going to have to kind of think that out. But anyways, from a pressure perspective, though, you're going to see here, this is PA counter go. Remember, I'm pass committing all the way. Snap of the ball here, PA counter go. And on that, you see, it's probably the best blocking you're going to get on this play. To be honest with you, PA counter go, like I said, probably the best protection that they're going to find with this defense. But again, if you do what I said, where you do that contain on the right, and then you have the blitz angle on the left, then what you see here is oftentimes, see how he pushes him right into the quarterback? And I'm telling you, that's so much more consistent than you might think. You're going to get a lot of those sacks where, you know, you're just kind of pushing the pocket into the quarterback, and then they're just going to shed and instantly sack them, even if they're blocking people, right? Now, let me show you something else here. So let's say, for example, that I just release the running back just like that. That's probably the best chance they have of picking this blitz up, to be honest with you. Now, let's say they let the whole play action animation go. This is where it's going to get really nasty. So if they let the whole play action animation go like this here, typically you're going to get pressure right there. We didn't, probably just because I was standing in the wrong spot. Ideally, you don't even have to blitz your user. You could literally just do this right here if you wanted to. But ideally, you're just trying to suck this tackle into an animation. Okay, that's all we're trying to do. Just suck him in. If we don't get him sucked in, we can actually use a rush on this as well. But again, this is just one of my favorite blitzes because it's so simple to set up. It's really, really easy to set this up. Literally just globally blitz your linebackers, and then you're just going to move this guy over here. That's literally all we're doing. And then now you'll see here he sucks in. Look at that running back go to the right, and as you can see how that worked out for the quarterback. The same thing with trips tight end. Let's say, for example, that they are sending five players on a route. Then this blitz is going to come in 100% of the time. So again, you go hard flats or something like this, they suck right into you, and as you can see, you're going to get instant pressure against trips. This is easy, very easy pressure, and very, very effective against the trips tight end. Now, if you like this video, you want to learn more about defending trips tight end sets and getting some of the best blitzes to come in, we have two-man blitzes that literally sending two people that will come in against max protect out a bunch. We've got great trips tight end stuff out of there. We just revamped a lot of the nickel triple stuff as well as a lot of the other new defenses that we're going to be putting into the ebooks or into the Patreon here shortly. So if you want to get in on this, like I said, it was really a great deal for just $10 a month. If you sign up for the Patreon, you get everything. Literally, $10 a month, you get everything. So if you want to sign up for it, head on down to the description below, click that link, head over, check out the Patreon. I promise you, you won't be disappointed. You will find so much content and so much that you can really kind of consume and then be able to execute in game. I guarantee your game's going to go to the next level just by having 24 hours in the Patreon. You're going to get so many concepts that you may have not already known about, or you're going to get more detail as to why they work. So if you're watching this and you want to take your Madden game to the next level, head down to the description below, sign up for the Patreon for just $10 a month. You're going to get access to everything. Thanks for watching the video, and we'll see you guys next time.